Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I'm somewhat surprised because I have just come back from a road trip. I was in Boston, actually in Cape Cod, delivering a mastermind to a group of really intelligent people all about productivity. And what blew me away is how they were blown away by some of the most basic, simple things that I thought everybody knew about personal productivity in technology. I think I just sit too close to the topic all the time. So I forget that people out there doing their real work on an ongoing basis, doing their real job, don't have time to dive into it the way I do. So today I'm determined to take you back to basics. Let's go back and take a look at what I consider to be the five main reasons that you should consider using Gmail as your prime email client. That's today on Dotto Tech. All right, I got to thank my good friend, Sue B. Zimmerman, the Instagram gal. She is an awesome hostess. She put together a webinar. She had a little forum, a conference called Sail to Your Success, which I attended. It was awesome. And on the back side of that, she invited me to join a lot of her community and put on a productivity mastermind. And we were just going to look at some basic, simple things. We're going to look at email overload, and we're going to look at Evernote. And I thought, that's great, and I look forward to it. But I was really concerned that they were going to get great value out of the presentation that I was giving, because they were taking time out of their day, they were coming out to Cape Cod, they were spending money. You want to make sure you give people value. So when I started in on my Gmail part of the presentation, which is just talking about using Gmail as the basis for your email software, what really took me aback was how surprised they were with some of the things that I considered to be basic features. And it opened my eyes to the fact that when you spend time in the productivity space the way that I do, the tools and features become second nature. When you spend time doing your job, the tools can be a little bit mysterious because it's not your job to know how they work, it's your job to make them work. So actually diving in and knowing what the different things will do for you, that can be sometimes a bit of a mystery. So let's step back. And it's not that I love Gmail that much. I don't think Gmail is the be-all, end-all. Do I think it's the best actual email client? Probably not, but it's often the best choice. And I'm going to give you the five reasons that I think it's the best choice today. So let's start with reason number uno, or one. The first tool that people don't seem to know that they always have at their fingertips is the ability to open multiple accounts or multiple email addresses in Gmail. So your existing POP or your existing IMAP email account that you are, say, accessing in Outlook or some other client, you can actually import that into Google, into Gmail, and be able to access all those different accounts at the same time. So let me show you very quickly the process that you go through to do that. With so much that goes on in Gmail, we start under this gear icon right here in the upper right-hand side, which is the settings. Going into the settings opens a browser window with all of your Gmail settings available to you, and there's a lot of settings. This is one of the challenges, I think, of Gmail, is even though it's so it's free, it's not complex. It's got a lot of features, a lot of buttons, a lot of places you go. So some of the dedicated email clients might seem a little easier to use just because the tools are more at your fingertips. It's kind of better thought out as far as the ergonomics goes. And they are probably a lot easier to use in a lot of ways. But they don't do the things that we want to do in Gmail. They don't give us the kind of ubiquity and the other features that I'm going to be talking about in a few moments. So it's worth learning to navigate our way through these different menus. Now, in order to set up multiple accounts, you're ultimately going to go into your accounts and import area here, which is going to set up for you to have multiple Gmail or multiple email addresses. But before you do that, you have to pop over into the labs and enable something called multiple inboxes right here. This allows your Gmail account to access at the same time multiple inboxes. So you just got to go through and enable that. Once you've done that, you click on the Accounts and Import tab here. And down here, you go and you create and import a new email address. And most of the time, you're going to be doing it down here in this one from using POP3. And that's just the old school email address that you had on your server. So it's a pretty straightforward process. You add a POP email account you own. And this, it can be frustrating, even though it's simple. You type in the email address and follow your way through the steps. You'll have to put in your password. It will try and find the server for you automatically. There's the odd time that you're going to have to kind of work your way through a few different issues getting your email address imported, but it's worth the effort because once you have your email address imported here, then your Gmail account will pull and will pull down email from all of your different accounts. Now, we'll use things like we'll use tags. You can see most of my email comes to one account because you can see just by the tagging, it's all coming to my main Dotto Tech account. But you can add labels and folders that will sort the email so you can quickly identify which account it's coming from based on the color of tag as it comes in. I'm not going to dive into that right now because that is an extra feature, but it's not one of the most compelling reasons to be using Gmail. And I have other videos on that, so if you're watching all of my videos, you'll certainly be able to see that as well. So number one is we can import multiple accounts, bring them all together. Now, one comment that came up from one of the people at my conference at the mastermind was it was a full stop on Gmail because they didn't like how Gmail nested the emails together, their reading options, and they never took a look inside, once again going back to the area in settings where we have multiple options. Now I've got my Gmail set up right now for nested email and I don't really like that. That's where you have kind of one subject and it includes all of the follow-up emails within that. It does do a good job of cleaning up the number of inboxes in your or number of messages in your email inbox. But sometimes if you're dealing with a long thread, it makes you can get lost within the thread. We all know that. It's all happened to all of us. So if you want to, you can just go here into the conversation view, once again in the settings area, and turn conversation view off. Now, every time you make a change here in the settings in Gmail, you have to remember to scroll to the very bottom of the screen, and you've got to save the changes. Once I've done that, I should be able to go back in, and now where I had nested conversations, I actually have more email messages now in my inbox than I did before, but all of the nested conversations are now independent emails, which are a little bit easier for me to manage and deal with. Now, please do not judge me. I do have 160 messages in my inbox, which is outrageous as far as the number of messages, but I have been on the road for a week. I'm just back today recording this demo before I've actually cleaned out my inbox because email is a second priority to me. I wanted to get a good video in the can today. So after I've done with you right now, I'll be inspired and I'll go back in and my email will be down to white space at the bottom in no time. So don't sweat my 160 messages. I'm not sweating it at this point. The next thing I wanted to talk to you about is the different sorting options that they have. And this is an area that Gmail, when they launched this feature, there was a lot of backlash. A lot of people didn't like it. Personally, I love this feature. You see here along the top of my Gmail inbox, I have a variety of different tabs. What Gmail does is because Gmail comes from Google and they're the search people. They know how to categorize information as it flows. They've looked at more email than anybody in the planet. So they recognize what's primary email, what's ones that you should be dealing with, that people you write back and forth to, the most important messages. They recognize what's coming from social networks like Google Plus and Facebook and Twitter. They recognize what's a promotional thing. Hey, Steve, buy this. And they recognize what are updates, which are things like newsletters and things like that. So they recognize the different categories of information, and they automatically sort all of our email into those categories. So typically speaking, when I check my email, I just look in the primary email on a kind of every time I check my email basis, and every once in a while I poke my head into the social and I see what people I see what's going on here. But for the most part, I'm getting the feedback that from social, from people posting on my wall and stuff like that, when I actually visit my Facebook account or when I go onto Twitter. So it's not as important for me to have it here, although it's a nicety to have it. The promotions, I hardly ever look at. Those are people selling me stuff for the most part, and I do go in and look every once in a while just to check it. Maybe once a day, I look and see if there's anything important, because sometimes you will get an important email in accidentally into one of these areas, and when you do, when it's something that you actually want to have in your inbox, in your main inbox, you just grab it, drag it across, and see what it says, move one conversation. It will then move it, and if I say, yes, I want to move everything that comes from the MaxStation marketing department into my inbox, now that email will always arrive as my primary inbox, which you could also say is important email. You could name it something different. Same with the updates. Now, how you enable this is, once again, under said gear icon. We go into the gear icon, and you configure your inbox. By configuring the inbox here, click on that, That opens up a little dialog box here, or a little pop-out, that allows you to turn on or off these sorting tabs. Now, a lot of people in internet marketing hated these sorting tabs because it meant that their newsletters and email ended up in the updates or promotions folder unless people moved them across. Personally, I love it. If I give you good enough value in my email that I send out to you, like my promotional email, that you read it all the time and you move it into your inbox, as far as I'm concerned, that's fantastic. If you just want to see it occasionally in the update area, that means I'm not doing as good a job as I could possibly with my email information, with my content in my newsletter. And so at any rate, for the end user, this sorting feature is an absolutely brilliant concept that I have really taken to. If you don't have Gmail, if you decide you're not using Gmail and you're going to stay in Outlook, you can add the same kind of functionality using a third-party tool like a SaneBox or something like that. The next thing that I wanted to talk about is calendar integration. Now, one of the reasons that I originally left Apple Mail and started to look at Gmail seriously was Apple Mail's integration with calendaring apps sucked. And so many of our appointments are generated by email. So having to go into the calendar and manually enter all of the information was absolutely insane as far as I was concerned. Now, you will find that in Gmail, your calendar integration comes in a variety of different ways. Sometimes, as you read an email, if the syntax is proper and people have sent you a suggestion within the email, there'll be an actual blue underline underneath the date. And if you just click on that, you can automatically add it to your calendar. But even if that doesn't work, because it's one of the mysteries why it works sometimes and why it doesn't. Even when it doesn't work, take a look here. My dentist is reminding me that I have an appointment coming up on October 21st. Now, theoretically, this should have highlighted for me, and I should be able to navigate to it directly. But I can't. So I can, instead of that, I can go under the More menu here, and I can create an event. This means that it takes the email and it references it into the calendar appointment. I create the appointment right away. When I look at the appointment in my calendar, I'll just save this and then I'll show it to you in the calendar. When I save this, I don't need to send it to any other people. When I save it, it is, let's go to the proper calendar place here. It's next week. It should be saved Tuesday. Oh, sorry, it's the 21st. I'm looking in early October. 21st of October, there it is. My appointment reminder. If I click on that, it now brings up the text of the email so that I have all of the information there. Booyah! I just absolutely love that feature. And speaking of integration, when you're in your Gmail app in the browser, you've always got access through this little tool right here. See this tool here, which says apps? You've always got access to Google Drive, your calendar, and other Google services. So the integration with your entire world is pretty great here as well with using Gmail. Now, the next thing that I wanted to talk about is the add-ons that we have within Gmail. Now, there's two add-ons that I recommend everybody use that has Gmail. The first is called Boomerang. And Boomerang, you can try it out for free, and you can use it to a certain extent for free for a lot of, in a light form, and then you can upgrade to the paid version. But what it does is it allows you to manage your email in a variety of ways. The first is, if you have a message in your inbox that you don't want to deal with right now, but you want to deal with in the future, rather than waiting for that email to, rather than leaving it in your inbox, you can boomerang that email, send it out of your email, have it kind of sit out there in cyberspace for a little while, and then return at a predetermined time so that it's not top of mind, it's not bothering you. Similarly, if you assign a task to a coworker, you forward an email to them, you can set up a boomerang notification to let you know when they reply, if they haven't replied. So you can say in 3 days, if they haven't replied to this, remind me. And that works great for customers or coworkers. But what I find also to be the kind of the magic sauce in Boomerang is you can schedule. If I create a new email message right now, and I was going to write it, and are you one of those people that writes, that does their email at 11:30 at night sometimes? If you start sending your email at 11:30 at night, a couple of things happen. I don't mind you doing it at 11:30 at night. That's your own personal choice. But look at what it says to the world. It says, I'm available at 11:30 at night if somebody receives an email from you at 11:30 at night. And suddenly they engage in a conversation. So one of the participants in my mastermind was a realtor. And she said that she replies to email all the time at 11 o'clock at night. So I recommended to her that she reply at 11 o'clock at night and get it off of her chest, you know, kind of get it out there. But use this boomerang feature right here to send it later. and not to send this message at 11 o'clock at night, but send it at 6:30 tomorrow morning. They don't have to know that, that you're not an early riser, but rather you're late to bed. And it's a far more appropriate time to engage in a conversation at 7 or 8 in the morning by email than it is continuing through late into the night. So you can acknowledge, you can deal with all of the details, get it off. And the main reason that she wants to reply is to get it off her shoulders. But then she can do that. And at the same time, she can have the she can take care of her client and not get sucked in to a long conversation. The other tool that I use an awful lot is one called Reportive. And Reportive allows me to take a look at any, is that kind of one going to come up? No, he doesn't have much of a social profile. Poor Bill. He doesn't have a lot of social profile. He's a great guy, not a lot of social profile. So let's go, Lou. I met Lou at a conference. He's a great YouTube guy. So when I click on an email coming from Lou, I see here, I get the social context. I can immediately, with Reportive, the tool Reportive, I can immediately add him to my circles in Gmail, and I can see other information depending on how connected I am with him. If I click here on Show Details, it'll show all the emails that I've had from him to him. So I get all sorts of contextual information based on the social profile of the person who I'm having a conversation with. And depending on how many things you're connected. Like, I'm not connected on LinkedIn with Lou yet, but if I was, I would see that information coming through. Actually, Reportive was purchased by LinkedIn, so we're going to see a lot of additional features. But it's a great way to add social context as you communicate with people through Gmail. And the last thing that I want to talk about is, so far as last features, I haven't been kept count, but I think I've gone through 4 main features. The last one is really the biggest, and that's the ubiquity of Gmail. Because Gmail is a cloud-based service, as soon as I get a new notebook computer or a new tablet or a new phone, all I do is sign into my Google account and my entire Gmail account is available to me instantly. And it's the same on all platforms. So you're working with the same email if you're on your notebook, when you move to your desktop, back to your tablet, you've got the same access to the exact same content. Nowhere is that more relevant than when we are on our phone. So if we go back and we take a look at my Gmail account right here, let's just put it back into my inbox. You can see I've got social promotions updates. I've got a certain amount of email. I've got my newest email here in my inbox. When I go and I open my Gmail on my smartphone, I see the exact same email, down to the same color coding. If I click here on the side, just because the screen's obviously smaller, I have the same folders that I can store things in. I have access to all the same accounts, the same email addresses that I want to send and receive from are all available to me right there from the phone. So that this ubiquity of service with your email is absolutely huge. You won't know how valuable it is until the day that your main computer hard drive crashes. And while you're busy going through a recovery process of all of your backed up files and all of those other things, as soon as you get that new notebook or as soon as the new hard drive is installed on your existing, on your old notebook, as soon as you fire up a web browser, fire up Chrome, sign into Gmail or sign into your Google account, and you've got back in business for all of your email, all of your calendar, all of your contacts, it's just there, and all of your stored documents on Google Drive, that's the moment where you say, wow, for all of the extra hassle that I went through dealing with Gmail and a Google account, it was worth it for this moment. You never know when that's going to come, and it might never come, but it's absolutely worth it when that moment comes. Well, this was a bit of a long demo today, wasn't it? But it's good to kind of get back in the saddle, get back in the studio, and get recording again after being on the road for the better part of a week. I hope that you found a lot of value in today's video. There's 3 ways that you stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. First, please subscribe to our channel. Second, please sign up for our newsletters. I send out a weekly newsletter, and I let you know about my live events as well as any webinars that I'm doing and that sort of stuff. So that's all available in my newsletter. And finally, Dotto Tech is a crowdfunded site. We are actually supported by you, the people who view this content and value it. And if you visit my Patreon page, you'll learn what crowdfunding is. It means you give me a few dollars a month, and in return, I don't have to go chasing money and sponsors. Instead, I can concentrate on providing good and compelling content, which I hope this was a prime example of. So please visit my Patreon page. And with that, until next time, have fun storming a castle.